All right, so our country right now is hurting, and we have a lot of protests going on in multiple cities, and especially in Minneapolis right now.
And corruption.
Yes, and but the U.S. is not the only place that's hurting right now from protests and government upheaval and stuff, things like that. Hong Kong right now is going through their own turmoil, and recently China has passed a new bill that would basically end democracy in Hong Kong.
God damn, it actually went through?
They're drafting it, the bill now. They passed it, and now they're drafting it.
Why are they speeding it up? I thought like they were gonna wait, like, we'll give it to you guys in like 50 years.
Yeah, the reason I feel there's like a little, I have my opinions on why there is, but yeah, the little backstory is that in 1997, Hong Kong was still a British
territory,
yes. And in 97, it was given back to China, and because China at the time wasn't in economic prosperity, and Hong Kong was, England and like U.S., like the major power players at the time, were like, you know, Hong Kong is lucrative for us. Let's keep it a free economy and like let's run business through Hong Kong. But so
they were independent kind of from
China. Yeah. So it's like the thing they call it was one country. Wait, is it one country, two economies or something like that?
I forgot what it was, but they allowed Hong Kong to operate as if it's its own country, and they promised Hong Kong that they weren't gonna touch it.
For 50 years.
They're gonna eventually transition it into the Chinese system, but they were gonna let it have its own currency, its own government, and all that stuff. The problem came up as a little backstory. Basically, it came as a question of extradition, right?
Yes.
A Taiwanese couple, a Hong Kong couple went to Taiwan for vacation. And what people don't know is Taiwan is actually still part of China, where Taiwan wants to be independent, but they're not recognized as that. Mm-hmm. But China still sees Taiwan as a part of China. So there's the whole mess there too.
Right.
So a Hong Kong couple went to Taiwan, and I guess like there's allegations that he killed his girlfriend there when he came back. So they wanted to extradite him in China.
Yeah. Send him to mainland and punish him through mainland laws.
Law, right. But then Hong Kong erupted and said, wait, he's a Hong Kong citizen.
Yeah.
If he does that without any questions, that means you can grab us up. Yeah. And then they found out that there were anti-Chinese bookstores in Hong Kong that basically they had authors and basic content. That the whole bookstore wasn't like a propaganda bookstore. They just so happened to have a few authors and writers that produced content that was against the Chinese government. But for some reason, those bookstores owners were kidnapped, taken away. There's just all kinds of crazy shit that went down like that.
How popular is this bookstore? Because I'm just picturing like
It's a couple of small ones. But that's when Hong Kongese people were like, oh shit. We're not protected here because they could grab us up at any moment and take us into China. And that's kind of like the backstory of like, hey, you said China, you would let us basically trial our own people, bring them through our own system.
Govern ourselves.
Right, so you're just grabbing people up and trialing them in China. And so—
And extradition to China is a death sentence for a lot of people.
Absolutely.
Right.
I mean, they're not gonna come back.
No.
Yeah, they don't have the same judicial system that we do. Well, Hong Kong is closer to the West because it was a British colony and a territory. So then they run it more like a British system. And that's what the citizens there like. And they don't want to be controlled by a communist government because the way that they do things is completely different culturally. So that's a little backstory on China versus Hong Kong.
True. And I also think it's a two birds with one stone move for China because they're silencing the pro-democracy things that's happening in Hong Kong. And on top of that, backstory with their relationship with China and US, obviously the COVID thing has also dampened the relationship between China and US. But before COVID happened, back in 2017, Trump also put on tariffs on all Chinese imports into the US. China didn't like that, because it deterred US people from buying Chinese goods or whatever, and we're trying to keep our US goods within ourselves and be autonomous that way, right? And we don't need Chinese people to help us. And so I feel like there's a bit of a retaliation here too, where U.S. actually does a lot of business with Hong Kong, and I think the number was like $127 billion, wow. Something like that, just through Hong Kong. And Hong Kong is kind of like the portal to tap into the Asia, the Chinese Asia, market, yeah. And just Asia in general.
Well, especially the tech world, too.
The yeah. tech world.
Yeah, because we do a lot of, you know, America's do fuck tons of business with China, too, but it's all like, you know, a lot of textiles or iPhones, there's like small, like low wages and stuff. Like the tech stuff is a lot more lucrative in Hong Kong.
It's huge. And like with the tech stuff, too, like a lot of Chinese companies, like a lot of tech companies in the US and also just companies in general, like it could be clothing, could be tech, could be whatever it is. Like they want to get their products in China because there's a lot of money there now. But in order to do so, Chinese companies and the government, because a lot of stuff is just, it's all owned by the state, right? So then they are basically manhandling all these US companies and basically stealing intellectual properties, you know, Alibaba, like they're just literally just taking ideas and then doing it for cheaper, selling for cheaper, and selling it back to US. And so yeah. Trump's like, I don't want that either. And so he's also set up a lot of, with the tariffs, I forgot what the
sanctions?
The sanctions, yeah. So he's trying to prevent all these things. And I think this is China's way of saying, well, fuck you, Trump. We're gonna take Hong Kong away from you. We're gonna take all your businesses away that you have happening in Hong Kong. And holy now it's under China. So then all the Hong Kong stuff. Oh yeah, Hong Kong is also has a special immunity for the tariffs. Because of all the business,
yeah.
So they don't actually have the import export shit going on in Hong Kong
until
you want to talk about
like
the Pompeo
3 days
thing?
Ago. Mike yes. Pompeo said that they no longer consider Hong Kong independent from China, which means that they see them as the same entity. So
fuck.
That means a lot of American businesses, a lot of businesses in the world, are like, oh fuck, now we have to deal with China. That's not as fun at all as Hong Kong, which was a free market economy.
Exactly.
So now we're considering moving our business elsewhere. So places like Singapore and Vietnam are like, fuck yes, give us your business.
Yeah. Yeah. So Hong Kong people are basically looking at the end of free speech and the end oh, of shit. Economic prosperity. Like it's gonna just tank.
Who signed that like, I don't know, it's a contract or whatever. Like it was between who and who? Like Hong Kong and China, or there was the U.S.
So
and China?
So Hong Kong was protesting against Hong Kong government because the Hong Kong government is trying to go with China.
But that bill though, right? The initial bill that said, hey, you guys can operate as independent as you need to be for those 50 years, who was it?
It wasn't a bill, it was basically the British government told China that they'll
give it back.
License Hong Kong for 100 years. Mm-hmm. They because it was a shipping port for them, and so at that time after the 100 years went up, I think it was in 99 or something like that. That's when
97.
That's when it was given back to China. But at that time, Hong Kong had its own government, had everything going on, and it was kind of gray area. So after 97, I think they were just operating normally until as of recently, it just came as a storm. Based off of what I'm reading is that recently everything erupted because of the extradition and all these things and Hong Kong citizens being kidnapped.
Yeah, and the protesting, it angered China. So China's like, you know what, you're pissing me off. We're just gonna do this right now. And so
I don't think there was a real agreement, so to say. And I heard that within the Hong Kong government, the way that they broke it down is China slowly started to bring in more pro-Chinese parliament people. So prior to that,
it was going to happen anyway.
Yeah, and then the people that appoint the parliament or whatever, they were given a list of who's allowed to and who isn't. So then their system also got corrupted because even though it's quote unquote democracy or whatever, it's more pro-choice, pro-China politicians.
Right.
Which will vote toward China. So then the people felt like, what the fuck is this? And then the mayor or the governor, whoever, she basically stepped out of it.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. But yeah, so this
crazy.
All this stuff is just it's ironic now, and it brings us to the point of like
the whole world is
yeah, and the irony is that yeah, over here we have democracy, and And like you were saying off camera at one point, you were saying like, you know, Marxism and like socialism and all that stuff is getting more popular here.
Yeah.
Whereas they're fighting against Marxism and socialism, and they're trying to get democracy happening in Hong Kong.
Yeah.
And so it's just, it's a backwards fight, but the battlefield looks eerily similar.
Yeah, it's crazy, wow. Man.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Dude, it's crazy. They've That's been going on for shot. Months.
Yeah.
Protesting for months.
Yeah, it was, I think, I mean, this has been going on all last year too. You guys remember?
Yeah.
Dude, I saw like a couple of people light this guy on fire, and I was like, what
the fuck? Shit.
What? Yeah. They light him up on fire because I think I don't remember what he said, but it was obviously something that the two guys disagreed with, and so they threw like gasoline on him and then they like lit him up.
I saw footage last year of them hiring like triads and gangsters, and it's crazy, dude. So like they hired a bunch of thugs to go into the protesters and start slicing them up with machetes.
Oh my god!
Yeah,
it got violent.
And then you have to be careful, like when you're wearing all black clothing, because even though you're not partaking in the protest, like the police officials like would assume that you are a part of that, and so they'll try to like take you down.
Damn.
You have family there, right?
I don't have any. I don't have any.
Yeah, well, they have
what's
family.
What's going on?
They're saying it's still early, but you know, they're saying, you know, there's reports about people disappearing and stuff. You know, like very vocal activists are disappearing.
Or even not vocal, who were doing things subtly on the internet, say.
Yeah, they're just, they're disappearing.
Yeah, I don't know why communism is getting so popular, because we have so many immigrants here that ran away from communism. You would assume that they would tell these stories to their kids and stuff, or do they just glamorize it, or maybe they like cherry pick some ideas? Because it's dangerous, because only because we know, like, from our friends and family, like, how they ran away from it. And, like, even Bart's dad literally said his neighborhood, people were getting kidnapped by the government and
locked. Kick in doors
gone.
And take you.
They
yeah.
just disappeared yeah. the next day. Yeah.
And I met some Eastern Europeans, and they just got out of communism, like, in the 80s. Yeah. And they have stories of the same thing, dude. They just, the government has so much power, they just snatch up people in your neighborhood and they go disappearing.
Mm-hmm. I feel like the people that like it might like the theoretical communism, not the actually applied communism.
And I agree. Theoretically, on paper, I'm like, that sounds nice, you know?
Yeah, and I read Marx, and I think there's a lot of great ideas, but it's, I don't know, man, like, in practice, communism seems scary.
Because of the limiting factor of the biggest thing that limits, I think, communism to me, even in the utopian sense, is the idea that if you're a kid and the government determines that you should be this certain job and your dream was not to be that certain job, that never works out.
Yeah.
So like you're supposed to do everything for the society, everything for the group. And so if a kid is told he has to be a doctor, but he's like, I don't want to be a doctor, I want to be an artist or whatever. Too bad. This is what the system has chosen for you. Why don't you care about society? Why do you hate your neighbors? And that's
like you're, yeah, I don't
it's
know.
Limiting. It's limiting.
Yeah.
It's limiting. And that's anti-human, I think.
Yeah, but I think it's because people hate the crony capitalism and
yes.
the corrupt capitalism in the US so much that they're going the other way, which is fucked up, because I'm like, damn, dude, like, it's not what it is, you know?
I wish that we could, because, like, you know, a lot of bad talk about socialism from a lot of people, right? But some things in our system are socialistic, right? Like,
yeah, like
our
unions,
education system,
education,
unions, all this stuff. Police, fire, all that stuff. I wish that we could take human beings the same way that we take kids. Like, if you're a kid and you go to a certain school, there's a certain amount of money that's attached to your backpack almost every time you go to school. And when you don't go to school a lot, you don't. The school system doesn't make as much money. If we did that for healthcare, where the person has a amount of money attached to their person, and wherever they go, it gets paid for and the check clears, I'm for that. I'm not for
Sounds
the.
Right.
And that's why I'm open to things like Medicare for All stuff that a lot of people fucking hate, because I think that our system right now is just like, you're on your own, good luck. And then the crony capitalist part of it is like, hey, as long as you're connected with people, you don't have to ever worry.
Mm. Yep.
Yeah, our hearts go out to you, Hong Kong, and Minneapolis, and all over the world, I guess.